What conspiracy theory do you believe to be true? What evidence led you to this conclusion? Marilyn Monroe was murdered by the US government. She frequently attempted suicide and then called someone via her landline next to her bed to come save her. When she died, no traces of it were found within her stomach and her colon had been extremely cleaned. A theory is that she was murdered via enema poisoning. I haven't brushed up on it or researched in a long time, so I am probably remembering facts incorrectly. Search it up on YouTube, it's quite interesting. No way. The top comment that was just deleted talked about fake gilding from admins in order to gain traction on posts and it was deleted, I believe it now. Used to live in a small town in South Dakota and I am convinced there is something in the food water there to keep people there. Impartially convinced it's actually the Dairy Queen causing this. Because for a town of 7,000, this place is always so busy and somehow, every year for the past 11 years, the entire length of this competition, sells the most blizzards on Miracle Treat Day. A town of 7,000 outsells every other Dairy Queen. There's also some other things in that the town has a significant amount of people all with very similar disabilities to their left legs. I honestly am just glad I'm out of that town before it sucked me in. But how the heck does that small butt town sell 40,000 blizzards in a day? The stories about Dan Schneider. Watching some clips of shows he produces is downright creepy. The tweets of his actress's feet don't help his cause. Not a doubt in my mind the stories about him are true. I grew up watching all those shows and in retrospect there is so much creepy stuff in them. There's just so many scenes of underage actresses in bikinis, so many really obscene jokes about characters who are literally middle schoolers, and obviously a ridiculous amount of foot fetish stuff. It's very obviously true. That Reddit mobile is purposely broken to make you download the app. I forgot to include my proof. Basically, when I started using Reddit roughly 5 or so years ago it worked fine. Now ever other page loads as page not found frickin' GIF cut makes to go to their website just to view a 5-second GIF. Plus to top it off they keep pushing the app on me that I already downloaded but refuse to use. It works terribly. False because app is also broke. I keep ink pens from every year dating back to 2008 in my desk so that if I need to forge and backdate an important document I can sign it with ink that matches the year I'm backdating. Yes, feds do check ink in fraud investigations, not really a conspiracy but might answer a few questions. You don't need one of each year, just use a pen from 2008 and it could feasibly have been used any date after that. Restaurant owners know how awkward it is to be sung to in front of the whole establishment, and they do it to discourage people from taking advantage of their free birthday food. Bro, I'll jerk off in front of the staff if it means free food. I hate radio coordinates commercials breaks to all take place simultaneously so you're forced to listen to ads even you change the station. They're practically a monopoly in my area and I notice it happens to me all the time. Every time someone posts about a safe on Reddit, they actually have already opened it, and know nothing is in it before their first post. Also, people who never deliver on opening a safe after posting one found some really valuable crap in there and didn't want to put a target on their back. That the USA deliberately gets into an armed conflict every decade or so for the purpose of ensuring that at any given time, they always have a critical mass of soldiers with actual combat experience. They get in a lot of conflicts, and it seems highly probable that the leadership of a country that spends so much on national defense would highly value the institutional knowledge that comes from that kind of continuity of practical experience, even if it comes at a high human cost. Also, military-industrial complex. This is more of a personal conspiracy. I've been working as an American healthcare consultant for 2 years now, and I genuinely think that insurance companies are purposely denying claims so that they can leverage dollar sign for their beneficiaries' medical records. For example, one of my clients, a huge and important hospital system, had to deal with hundreds of thousands of dollars of medical claim denials because Humana suddenly decided it didn't believe any of those hospital stays were legitimate. They basically told my client to either fax hundreds of medical records or accept the zero pays. It's really suspicious and unfortunate, but when they have the money, what can you do? I bill Humana and they do that all the time. They send refund requests based on nothing and then we have to appeal by sending medical records and even that's a crapshoot. Humana rejection suck. Recently they stated in a denial that plain old physiotherapy was considered experimental treatment and they wouldn't pay for it. A forensics specialist believes Jamie Hewlett of Gorillaz is Banksy. It's not as big as other submissions here, but it's a theory I buy. The thing I like about these threads is that there are people reading these comments right now who know something important about the theories and they just aren't willing or able to provide that information here. That Apple started the AirPods meme, and right before Christmas they would give out $150 gift cards. I fully believe companies are using memes as a marketing technique. All it needs is one big post on a couple subs here and it's all over the internet hitting their target audience in our days. Disney made Zootopia partly to replace the Song of the South characters from Splash Mountain. Splash Mountain is really the only thing that still exists in the public eye from Song of the South, along with the song Zippa-Dee-Doo-Dah. Since Disney wants to pretend that movie doesn't exist, so they created a movie featuring Fox and Rabbit characters that could replace Bro Fox and Bro Rabbit. And Ray themed the entire ride to be Zootopia themed, while leaving some things, like the name, and the songs featured in the ride, from Song in the South. There's also that Disney loves Ray theming things to their IP now, getting rid of Maelstrom and bringing in a Frozen themed ride, so it would make sense for them to re-theme a ride to a successful recent movie then keep a ride based off an old, mildly xenophobic movie they are trying to forget. I could believe this, but Splash Mountain is so ridiculously popular that fans would riot if they tried re-theming it. I do like the part about the new Fox and Bunny though. I'm starting to think that the really stupid conspiracy theories, vaccines causing autism, flat earth, lizard people, etc., are intentionally spread by propaganda groups and troll farms. They don't care what stupid crap you believe, but they are very interested to know that you're a gullible mark who will believe anything with no evidence, and won't do research with authorities on the matter to find the truth. If you want to spread misinformation, look for the people who do it as a hobby. There was a report recently that Russian bot farms are spreading anti-vax memes in mass across US and Europe. Even if they may or may not have started it, they are certainly willing to capitalize off it. Mason jars created Pinterest to sell more mason jars. Me. Desperately trying to make a pretty salad inside a mason jar. Frick. The lines on the detergent caps are higher than they should be, so you use more detergent for each load of laundry. It's so easy for them to get away with it. I have a theory that Tinder gives fake you got a new match notification so people get excited and opens Tinder, which leads them to swipe more. Source: myself. That's not a theory, that just straight up happens, dog. The news report about beards containing more bacteria than a dog that just licked his own butthole. Beards are messing with facial recognition software. The man wants beards to not be trendy anymore. That article was also based on a sample size of 18 and lacked practically every kind of scientific rigor. Our apartment building has windows that are nearly impossible to affix a screen to. Same goes for the sliding doors. The power is centralized and locked into a certain expensive power company. I believe the developer and power company conspired to make people living in the apartments use the air con more by making it hard to keep windows open without dozens of mosquitoes coming inside. People asking about my language. I'm Australian. Thanks to draconian Aussie renting laws, I'm pretty limited in which modifications I can do. A lot of newer buildings are designed to look beautiful from the outside, and that means no screens on windows. I hate it. I love fresh air, but during the summer I either roast or let flies and mosquitoes into my apartment. I feel like drugs like C being cut with fentanyl. No dealer who wants to keep making money is going to cut their blow with fent. It seemed like drugs are being intercepted, cut with dangerous crap and then sent back out. Evidence: they already did the same thing during alcohol prohibition. The people doing it are convinced they are doing society a favor. Reddit works with the NSA. I see weird posts sometimes targeting my demographic to respond. Make sure to know you have no privacy here. I see some making throwaway accounts. Very smart. Despite it being a throwaway account, you still use the same IP address so they can still know it's you. I think the US made a secret peace plan with China after the Korean War. I base this on the way Chinese foreign policy changed so quickly and their lack of involvement in American wars in the decades to come. I think it fell apart in the 90s under Bush Sr. I used to tell people that I believed the government listened to our phone calls. Years later, some guy named Snowden proved me right. I hope the NSA knows that Jennifer was a freaking sea. I believe that there is only one ocean. My evidence: oceans don't have borders and there is nothing to separate them. Guys, this is a joke. If you're kidding, haha, I guess. But if not, you're correct, and science has recognized this. There are technically no oceans, and the oceans as a whole are referred to as the world ocean. The Hawaii nuke false alarm last year was actually the US government testing to see how the general population would react if an actual nuclear war broke out. I believe that the government probably makes some conspiracy theories to try to make questioning the government seem somewhat crazy. There is a conspiracy theory about the flat earth movement being just that. I think Apple is pushing their AirPods on consumers by making their software updates less and less compatible with wired headphones. My reasoning: my new headphones have started to consistently skip songs, activate Siri, stop and start music without me touching or even moving them. I asked around and other people are having the same issue. Not to be a tinfoil hat person, but tinfoil hat. I was having this problem too, weirdly enough. Just had to clean out the lightning port. Conspiracy: my local Jimmy John's waits until they have 3-4 orders to deliver before they bring me my freaking sandwich. Evidence: where's my freaking sandwich? This is proven. McDonald's McDelivery service asks its stores to wait an extra 20 minutes or so before heading out to deliver in case any more orders come in from the same location. They quote a 45-minute delivery time when most of their menu is not made to order and can be ready to go in under 5 minutes. Banks and landowners conspire to manipulate urban land prices. Turn an area into a ghetto by marking it as a high-risk loan proposition, denying loans in the area. Property values plummet on a downtown area because no one can sell, because no one can get a loan. But once things are down enough, you can buy up prime location land at pennies on the dollar, then redevelop it into being worth the real market value of such a central location, plus what you invested in the actual development. This is called redlining. It is illegal to do and there are many laws forbidding it. That's not to say banks don't do it, but it's illegal. Source: worked for banks and sold mortgages. When Ted Kaczynski, the Unabomber, was at Harvard, he participated in a brutal psychological experiment led by Professor Henry Murray. The experiment lasted for 3 years and by many accounts they seem to have an extreme impact on Kaczynski's psyche. I think this experiment was part of the CIA's MKUltra project and destabilized Kaczynski enough to where he eventually went on his reign of terror of sending bombed packages around the country. During the MKUltra project, the CIA collaborated with university professors on these mind control experiments, but a lot of the documentation was destroyed when people started to look into it. TLDR: the Unabomber participated in an experiment that was a part of the MKUltra project that eventually led to him becoming a mass murderer. Michael Jordan's father was murdered in retribution for Jordan not paying off massive gambling debt. Jordan didn't retire and then come back. He was suspended for gambling. In the mid-90s, Michael Jordan was an industry. The truth about his gambling habits may have cost a lot of people a lot of money, so the cover story was presented. I admit the part about his father's murder is a bit of a stretch, but this is a thread about conspiracy theories after all. As for the suspension, I stand by that 100%. Found Bill Simmons' Reddit burner account. I believe that chapstick causes lips to become more dry a couple hours after usage. I base this on the fact that my lips are more dry 5 hours after using chapstick than 2 days after using it. People just use chapstick wrong. It's to seal already existing moisture in the lips, not add moisture. Think of the difference between Vaseline and lotion. Chapstick is basically Vaseline. Arts Guild their own submissions from old accounts to give them traction. Source: the removed comments in this thread were discussing exactly that. The original comment itself was even gilded and removed in less than 30 minutes. The Bandersnatch Black Mirror Netflix special collected watchers' data to better green light productions that were more in line with users' taste. I wrote a complaint online about my pizza place about them cancelling my order without telling me, And the next order I got from them was fricked up. The pizza was way undercooked and not cut, and they didn't include the ranch that I always get with it. Also, when I called to tell them about the frick up, the manager seemed unapologetic and also like he already knew what I was talking about before I called. My conspiracy is that they retaliated since I basically reported them to corporate through their website with my initial complaint. I got a free pizza on my account with them for this, but decided just to not order from them anymore. A mediocre pizza anyway. I believe in the mattress store conspiracy. So the conspiracy is that mattress stores are for money laundering. I went onto Google Maps and typed in mattress stores near me. There were 4 mattress stores in the same shopping center. There was a road that had 5 mattress stores less than a mile apart. So I definitely believe in it. All my devices listen in on me. The other day I was arguing with my dad about some chicken I thought had gone off. It was frozen for about a month, so we weren't too sure, but my dad was insistent that it was still edible. Dad decided to ask Google, and lo and behold, the related searches even from the first letter were, is chicken edible after being frozen for a month, and how long can you freeze chicken before it goes off? Also, my mum and I use this tactic where if we need to ring up a company about something and it puts us in a queue, we swear at it. It then puts you on a priority list and you don't have to wait as long. Kinda sketchy on the company's behalf. Work with phone systems. Can confirm some can detect you swearing and increase the call priority. They also score both you and the agent based on a number of criteria. Malaysia Airlines Flight 370 wasn't an accident. There were definitely external forces that catalyzed its disappearance. The flight path was diverted many times and there was a lot of shady stuff about some of the passengers and the pilot of Flight 370. We may never know unless the plane is found. I've heard this before, but curious on what your thoughts are as to what may have happened to the plane and its passengers. That there is a huge pedophile ring in Hollywood. Anyone who tries to expose them die shortly after, coincidentally. That we didn't have an apocalypse in 2012, but instead shifted into an almost parody timeline of events. It's why humanity's future looks bleaker every year. There's a theory out there we shifted universes due to the Hadron Collider. I believe that Apple started the wearing AirPods equals cool rich meme intentionally to boost sales. They became the best-selling wireless earbuds worldwide after the meme. PETA was formed by meat companies to make animal rights activists look like idiots. Reasoning: the majority of animal rights activists don't like PETA. PETA wastes a lot of their own time calling out video games and cartoons. And they have killed many stray dogs for not being purebreds. I might have gotten some of the details of that last one wrong though. Well, if it's true, they are doing a fantastic job. The USA will never add colleges to public funding like they did high schools, because then the enlistment rate for the military would plummet. Source: everyone I know who joined the service just to help pay for school. This one is interesting. In addition to this, the federal government makes a ton of money off of student loans. Source: just took out $70K with 6%+ interest rate that will accumulate for a minimum of 4 years before I even start to pay them off. Multiply this by every student that doesn't default on their loans, and that is a lot of money. When a comment in one of these threads is removed, it's because it's true and someone with the power to remove it wants it hidden longer. I don't have evidence yet, but if this comment gets removed, then I'll have the evidence but no comment. Anyone saying now they wouldn't delete it because you called out the negative consequences. That was the point of doing so. Gotta keep the comment up somehow. Also, as tempting as it is, I'm not gonna delete the comment myself. It wouldn't be effective to the trained eye. Removed by moderator is hard to fake. And why falsify evidence when there's enough to go around? Half of you saw the thread about admins and gold. Why go any farther? I will watch this comment with great interest. What popular conspiracy theory is the easiest to shut down? My sister used to go on and on about the FEMA coffins. I guess they have thousands of coffins being stored, and the conspiracy theory is they'll cause a disaster for them to be used. The reality of it is very simple. If a natural disaster happens and thousands of people die, there needs to be a place to put the people. We don't just dig holes and make giant graves in the US. These coffins are there because any other supply of coffins does not exist, especially not localized in one area. They probably need them to help get the corpses out after their death squads roll through. You know about the FEMA death squads, right? The theory that they go in after natural disasters to kill more people for some reason. I really like the conspiracy theory that the Dark Ages did not actually happen. Some pope added a few centuries to the date and nobody said anything. Charlemagne is fake history. I did the report on this in high school. It's called the Phantom Time Hypothesis. Basically, the Eastern Roman Emperor Constantine VII, Holy Roman Emperor Otto III, and Pope Sylvester II teamed up and fabricated all of European history between the years 614 and 911, meaning the year they ruled landed on the millennium, which would legitimize the rule of the papacy due to some vague verse from scripture about the church's rule for 1,000 years. Otto put in the story of Charlemagne to associate the HRE with a heroic figure to legitimize the Carolingian line to the throne of the HRE. It falls apart pretty quickly when you take into account the fact that dating techniques have dated archaeological finds to this time period. Also, other civilizations like the Chinese have a trove of astronomical records from this time. Also, we're pretty dang positive the Muslim Arab conquests definitely, irrefutably happened and were a thing. Rainbows observed from sprinkler, using the city's water, is a naturally occurring phenomenon caused by light refracting through the droplets. It is not reliant on heavy metals. That Starbucks employees write the names wrong on purpose so people will tweet the mistake and generate free advertising. Yeah, a whole bunch of low-level, low-paid employees around the world decided to keep their mouth shut about it. The obvious answer is a combination of, they don't care enough to do it properly, because they make barely over minimum wage. They do it to be funny, because they are bored and like to mess with their co-workers who have to call them out. Serve millions of cups a day and there will be some funny misspelled names. The Paul is dead theory around Paul McCartney. My mom still believes it is true and buys into the even crazier theory that he was replaced by the government to help push LSD as a way for them to control the masses. The Pope is the great beast. His crown does not say Vicarius Filii Dei, it says Vicarius Christi. Therefore, the Roman numerals you can get from the crown do not add up to 666. Ironically, the founder of the Seventh-day Adventist Church, Ellen Gould White, adds to 666 using the same logic. I don't know if it counts as a conspiracy theory, but Bigfoot. I mean, the people trying to prove Bigfoot is real are in the woods hanging up donuts and cooking bacon to attract one. Come on. There was a dude who was interviewed about killing Bigfoot's kid or whatever, so my dad got all excited and I watched this interview with him. It was 45 minutes of Bull's history tracking Bigfoot, ending with the dude saying he felt bad so he freaking buried it somewhere in the woods and forgot where he buried the body. I mean, come the frick on. The rule of thumb I go by is if it affects the rich people, it's probably fake. X. Chemtrails must be fake because the rich and powerful breath air all the time. I'd say flat earth is probably the easiest to shut down. If you read, watch, and really investigate their arguments, it doesn't add up. I went down the rabbit hole trying to figure out the unifying why that makes FE supporters really believe and take hold of that view. Unfortunately, they are divided amongst themselves. Instead of finding a reason to support a FE narrative, they use a conceptual FE to support some other personal narrative. They blame NASA, Sneerpal, aliens, governments, or whatever is their personified villain of choice for manipulating the human race and then toss in a flat earth to justify their fear of the powers that be. Lots of other conspiracy theories have interesting points to debate or research, but I think FE is the easiest to shut down. Also, they all want you to do your own research. They'll never actually show what they've discovered. The trick is to out-conspiracy the conspiracy theorist. Just go one level of conspiracy deeper than they have yet gone. I call it conspiracyception. For instance, there's a guy who used to come into where I work, bar, who is a 9/11 conspiracist. Any piece of evidence, no matter how false, he put forward, I would use as evidence of an even deeper conspiracy to obfuscate what actually happened. Oh, you have images that show demolition charges going off to bring down the towers? Those are fake charges planted to make it look like there were planted charges that brought the building down. Oh, you claim that none of the passengers on the planes were real people, because none of their families ever came forward? Those people were all paid off to act like those people were part of some non-existent conspiracy. The beauty of this is its simplicity. No matter what evidence someone puts forward as evidence of a conspiracy, you can claim that this is, in fact, evidence of an even deeper conspiracy, crafted to cover up what actually happened. And what actually happened is what actually happened. In my experience, it works brilliantly, because one of the prime motivators for conspiracy theorists is to not be the one whom is fooled. If you can paint a scenario where all of their carefully researched evidence is, in fact, a smokescreen for what actually happened, you can, at the very least, get them to shut the frick up. Ooh, I like it. You can double down by saying something like, "See, now that they've got you digging into this fake moon landing crap, you're distracted from their real crimes and you're no longer a threat," and they get real hooked right there and they're like, "What? What could it be?" And you look side to side to see if anyone is listening, and you lower your voice and conspiratorially say, "Well, the one thing powerful people really want is to stay in power. In bad countries you just get a few death squads to kill your enemies. But here in America you have to be subtle about it. And so all I'm gonna say is, look at the shapes of the congressional voting districts. The truth is in the shapes. Who changed the shapes? And why? And now you've created an anti-gerrymandering monster who will harass politicians and do all sorts of research and legwork that he'll share with reporters and fellow citizens. And it turns out, since there actually is nefarious intent behind pretty much every single redistricting ever, he'll actually uncover conspiracies, which will just keep fueling his righteous fire. The Sandy Hook massacre was a government conspiracy. Easy, just talk to one of the parents and see if you're still standing. Disclaimer, please do not talk to the parents, Ray. Conspiracy theories. People who believe in the flat earth theory. Flat earther, the world is flat. Literally anyone, but 6th grade arithmetic. There is so much plain sight evidence for a round earth. You can watch things dip below the horizon. The phases of the moon. Lunar eclipses. Orbiting satellites in the night sky. The fact that I can't see China from my house. The theory that women can't touch their elbows behind their backs. I've personally confirmed this to be untrue with many, many women. Probably the one where black people used to be super geniuses who could also fly and use magic, and Africa was an advanced civilization and virtually every important historical figure was black, but then white people, who were inferior to them in every way, somehow managed to steal their knowledge, destroyed their civilization and erased all traces of its existence, suppressed their magic powers, enslaved them, and completely rewrote history. Thanks for spoiling the plot of Black Panther for everyone. That Obama wasn't born in the US, or that it would matter if he weren't. Since his mother was born in the US, he was be a naturalized citizen and eligible to run for president anyway. Ella Ted Cruz. Natural born, not naturalized. Naturalized means you were not a citizen at birth and became one later, meaning you would not be eligible to be president. That Sandy Hook, Las Vegas, and all the other mass shootings of the last few years were orchestrated by the anti-gun left in order to push legislation to further restrict gun ownership. They have passed almost nothing significant despite this, so you expect me to believe they are using the very thing they want to ban to rack up a body count and still can't get support to ban it? Passed nothing significant. Meanwhile, every time a mass shooting happens, gun sales go up as people feel the need to stockpile. The only ones who win in mass shootings are gun companies and their lobbying arm, the NRA. Chemtrails. You'd literally require airline ground crew at every major airport on the planet to be in on it without anyone talking. That's completely ridiculous. Any that require more than 100 plus to be in on the conspiracy or require rich, powerful people to change their behavior. The general rule is that a conspiracy gets less and less plausible the more people need to be involved in said conspiracy. For example, Flat Earth would need a massive navy to carry out a need to keep scientists, aerospace engineers and physicists quiet. So conspiracies that need a lot of people to carry out will be destroyed. But also conspiracies that involve whole groups of people, including The Jews control the world conspiracy. The every single Muslim is a terrorist out to kill you and they just pretend to be fractured conspiracy. The gay agenda. Any conspiracy involving Freemasonry. Any conspiracy involving the scientific and medical community. Any conspiracy involving the historical and archaeological community. This includes the we have a cure for cancer and are hiding it one in the moon landings. Jet fuel can't melt steel beams. Yeah sure, but steel loses 90% of its structural integrity at 50% of its melting point. There's also a thing hitting the towers that weighs 100s of tons at over 600 miles per hour. Chemtrails. Chemicals that far up wouldn't have any effect on us down here. The smoke is made from ice crystals. And you can easily check up on the planes using the internet. Which means you can see and track every plane you see. Really, any attempt on poisoning the air falls apart logically if you believe that whoever is supposedly in power and doing this also breathes air. Mandela effect, like the parallel universe part of it, there's so many fallacies with their claims, it's really easy to dispute. My understanding is that the Mandela effect is seen as a curious oddity of collective memory, and, I'll say most, people don't actually believe in a parallel universe. OJ was innocent and the LAPD were all racists who plotted to bring OJ down because he's black. Common sense alone can just shut that one down in a heartbeat. It's pretty obvious OJ did it and the LAPD tried to frame him. This will certainly get buried. Had a debate with my very conservative friend recently about clean energy versus coal and oil. When I mentioned that we were going to run out of oil soon, he responded by saying that we were going to find oil on the moon and Mars. I absolutely do not kid that he said that. I had a dang good laugh from that. Moon dinosaurs are real, dammit. None of them are easy to shut down. They all rely on unfalsifiable hypotheses or some kind of god stand-in. Take 9/11 for example. It was a government conspiracy. You're saying the federal government coordinated the largest attack on American soil and managed to keep it under wraps when hundreds of government employees would have had to completely compromise their morals to participate and keep quiet after the fact for 17 years. Yep, cuz government. They're powerful and pay people off and assassinate people and crap. And that's what it always comes down to. Some all-powerful vague entity, the villainous they. Some omnipotent force with enough money or influence to make it all happen. The god stand-in. You can build a case for any impossible scenario when you explain away the improbabilities where they have the power to do it. There is a cure for cancer but powerful pharmaceutical companies are keeping it hidden. If Steve Jobs couldn't afford it, it probably doesn't exist. The NBA draft lottery is rigged. Then why do small market teams like the Cleveland Cavaliers and Orlando Magic overcome long odds to win a disproportionate amount of the time? Lakers have been bad 5 years in a row yet have never landed the number one pick and it's been over 30 years for the Knicks, who started the conspiracy way back when. That doesn't disprove that the lottery was rigged that single time though. Which is where most of the controversies come from. I had a friend get indoctrinated by some documentary that was really just vegan propaganda. He tried to convince me at a Five Guys that humans aren't meant to eat meat. Really? Well, why aren't all our teeth flat molars like those of any herbivorous animal? We're sharp in the front, flat in the back. Evolution made us omnivores. I didn't say anything though because I just wanted to enjoy my fabulous burger in peace. My mom watched the same thing and turned vegan for 2 weeks. She tried to argue that the meat industry knew that they were the sole cause of cancer. There are some studies that say eating a ton of red meat could be a carcinogen. But so could tons of other foods, and was bribing politicians, doctors to keep quiet. We laughed at her every time we brought it up, and didn't try to argue with her. We encouraged her in a sarcastic way like, hey mom, tell us again about the meat conspiracy whenever her friends were over. That helped her realize how stupid she was being. That Diana, Princess of Wales, was murdered by the royal family. The theory goes that the Queen and or Prince Philip ordered to have her killed because she divorced their son. Prince Charles was no longer tied to the royal family, though she was allowed to keep her title as the Princess of Wales, and therefore behaved in a way that she couldn't as HRH. Dated some people, which included Dodi Al-Fayed, who some believe proposed to her, but there is a big belief within this conspiracy that she may have been pregnant with his baby and that is why they killed her. Anyway, the whole thing is stupid and here is why. It has been proven that, had she worn her seatbelt, she would have survived the crash. No one but her can control whether she does or doesn't fasten her seatbelt. The Queen does not have the power to order an assassination. Hundreds of years ago, monarchs ruled the land, but that ship sailed a very long time ago. If they murdered Diana for being controversial, why the heck is Sarah, Duchess of York, still alive? For any who don't know, Sarah married the Queen's other son, Prince Andrew, but divorced him around the same time as Diana and became a big media interest. The Queen would not, under any circumstances, order the death of her grandson's mother. Prince Philip adored Diana, and even attempted to counsel her and Charles when their marriage started to fall apart. Even if the royal family did have this power, which they don't, they would never commit an act such as this, knowing it would be recorded in public records that would be released decades later. Diana's son, Prince William, will become king one day. Any order for his mother's death would be revealed when he is head of state. Contrary to belief, close friends of Diana claim she wasn't in an active relationship with Dodi Al-Fayed, but was simply spending time with him in a date-like manner. So any pregnancy or proposal would be unlikely. The car that crashed was being pursued by paparazzi. These weren't actors or special agents. They were journalists and photographers. They witnessed the event and were responsible for it. Any suspicious activity prior to the crash would have been noticed and reported by them, particularly to remove blame from themselves. Here is the big one. If they are going to kill Diana, they have a ton of different ways in which they can achieve it and cover it up. They could drown her and say she slipped in the swimming pool. They could poison or smother her and say she died in her sleep, etc. Why would they ever have chosen to kill her in a way that was highly unpredictable, out of their control, in a public place, followed by journalists and photographers? The flat earth theory is easy, but only if you know the only specific way how to disprove it. I spent years working with a flat earther and discussing the science behind it and how everything works. Typically, those two attempt to disprove it don't understand a single aspect of the theory. People spend too much time trying to attempt disproving it by saying flat earth doesn't have supposed round earth 3x, which is dumb. Because obviously, if it's flat, it won't have round trays. Don't compare. Contrast. After 2 years of deep discussion, I've found that the only way to challenge the flat earth to a flat earther is with the prime meridian, or basically any measured distance from it to another, and with the southern constellations. The globe contains a series of wedges in it, divided by meridians. These wedges widen in shape at the equator only to shrink again at the next pole, at 15 degrees latitude north. The distance between two meridians is roughly 28 kilometers. At 0 degrees equator, the distance is 111 kilometers. At 15 degrees latitude south, the distance shrinks back down to 29 kilometers. On a flat earth, with those spider-webbed meridians, 15 degrees latitude south would be over 400 kilometers in distance between those meridians, which isn't the case. On a globe, the sky spins a different direction in the south than in the north, and shares different constellations. The flat earthers claim this is due to a double reflection of the top half of a disk above the top of the impenetrable dome that is our atmosphere, as opposed to the bottom half, which is the northern sky. What they forgot is that there's a southern counterpart of Polaris. Double reflection or no, since south is literally in every direction on the flat earth, that southern star would be visible in all directions, but actually, human perception would only allow you to see part of it. TLDR. If the earth were flat, Brazil would be twice as far away from South Africa than Quebec is from England, and there would be a solid shining arc across the entire relative southern horizon every night. Jet fuel can't melt steel beams. Whilst technically true, it's based on the false assumption that steel beams have to melt in order for a skyscraper to buckle under its weight. A great example of a strawman argument, because nobody ever claimed that the steel beams in the Twin Towers melted. It was just an assumption by truthers who have no experience in actual engineering. I'm no expert, and all I did was take one semester of strength of materials engineering to learn that you only need to reduce structural integrity by 50% for a steel column to buckle, which burning jet fuel is easily capable of. that Hitler escaped Berlin. His jaw was retrieved in 1945 and was independently identified by Western and Eastern intelligence agencies. That ominous bones that turned out to be genetically female were retrieved in 1946 on paranoid Stalin's demands. You don't need a DNA analysis to differentiate between a female and a male jawbone. What about Project Paperclip? I don't think any one person is what we should take away from World War II. A bunch of scientists and engineers who shared Nazi ideologies ended up in the US after the war. If be more worried about them than Hitler. What is the most ridiculous conspiracy you've heard? Recently I was told by this random woman that I should never have babies and if I do I should have them strictly at home without medical assistance because if you give birth at a hospital, they insert a listening chip into the baby so that the government can spy on you via listening chip somewhere in baby. 9/10 on creativity. I have a friend like this. She won't go to the hospital because she thinks they chip everyone who goes in there. She will die of something solvable one day because of this. Tetris is a virus invented by the Russians to turn us Americans into Game Boy zombies with no empathy for one another. Not sure where this came from, but the theory states, North Korea is actually a utopian socialist paradise and everything we've seen of it is just capitalist propaganda. Pretty sure it came from North Korea. The Malaysia Airways plane MH370, which disappeared in Indian Ocean, was in fact captured by US military, flown to Ukraine and intentionally crashed, full of already dead people. American courts are actually maritime courts, and you don't have to cooperate with them if you don't want to, because the flag has a gold fringe and the courtroom's bar resembles the bridge of a ship. People actually believe this. You're a crook, Captain Hook. Judge, won't you throw the book at the pirate? That space isn't real, that the moon and everything in space is a government projection, and that rockets go over the horizon when they launch because NASA just dumps them into the ocean. How about the most ridiculous one I made up? You see, in the town I grew up in there were only two people who did driver training and one of them, the cheaper of the two, was batshit crazy. He was ex-RCMP and whenever you went out driving with him it would take all of 2 minutes to start talking about all of the insane conspiracy theories that he believed in. He would go on about how the Jews did 9/11 and how the Bilderberg group built a secret weather control device in Alaska. Literally, every time you got in the car it would be wall-to-wall conspiracy theories. Anyways, while it was kind of weirdly amusing at first, I quickly realized that he seemed to believe any conspiracy theory he came across, so I started making up my own. I started off agreeing with him and then adding small, extra details, gradually working up to more ridiculous stories. Eventually, during my final session, where I had to drive about 40 minutes to the closest city, I basically summarized the entire plot of Metal Gear Solid 2 and he believed every word of it. I'm impressed that you can summarize MGS2 in 40 minutes. My neighbor believed Obama was going to access people's bank accounts and give their money to poor people. She withdrew her money and put in an $80,000 pool because Obama can't dig up a pool. Maybe she was trying to justify an expensive purchase and she really loves pools. All of the moon conspiracies. The moon is a hologram. The moon doesn't exist, etc. There's actually a book out there on Amazon about how the government built the moon. I would link to it, but I really don't want anyone to buy it. My favorite is how we've never seen the dark side of the moon in person, ever, and how that means there's something hidden there. My parents sincerely believe that there's a reason we haven't been on the moon since forever, and that's because there's aliens on the dark side of the moon or some crap like that. I've always had a soft spot in my heart for chemtrails. I tease Dark half the time. YWOULDNT, they just spray at night when you can't really see the trails. The only thing more powerful than a government-created mind control conspiracy is the Commercial Airline Pilots Union. My favorite is that the real Paul McCartney is dead, and the Paul McCartney we see today is just an imposter. I like to tease my girlfriend with this. The Mandela Effect. I remembered something incorrectly, therefore aspects of reality itself must be shifting. The Large Hadron Collider is sometimes blamed. If I remember things one way, and verifiable facts show things another way, then surely it's the verifiable facts that are wrong. NT really a conspiracy theory anymore. but my dad was certain Obama was going to enslave all white people as payback for slavery. He might be racist. Roswell, I had a guy telling me that President Truman made a deal with the aliens. All of our technological advances since 1948 have been parceled out to us by an alien race. In exchange, they get to take a few humans for experiments. That Malaysian airline, they needed a bunch of people that day. The guy was dead serious. The earth is hollow and people live in it. Harry Potter was written to turn people gay. 99% of moon-related theories are schizophantheories. Harry Potter was written to turn people gay. It doesn't even mention within the series that its one gay character is gay. If anything, I feel less gay after reading it. Too busy being satanic. I remember hearing whispers about the Pope wanting to kill every member of Knights Templar on a single night. How silly can rumors get? There's a lot, but the most ridiculous is probably flat earth. I had a guy going on about some physics and then asking me how come planes don't fly to space. An honorable mention would be these morons who expose themselves to diseases like freaking Middle Ages peasants because they think vaccination causes autism. There's this guy who lives in the subdivision a few streets down. It's a place that looks nice, so all the people think they are entitled and better. So this guy is a real nut job. He is a big conspiracy theorist. He believes Bigfoot lives in the woods we are surrounded by and is convinced that every camper to ever get lost in them is another victim of Bigfoot. He once showed my mom pictures he took of a plastered foot from Bigfoot that he found in the woods. It was a bear track. He even once tried to get those guys from television who yodel in the woods and then leave to film an episode here. It never happened. I was also once stuck in a car with him and his friend during Halloween. The friend's kid was at the door getting treats and the guy comes up and gets into the car and they start talking. It was cold that night, so I didn't want to get it, and to be honest, I really wanted to know what they were talks about. I didn't know at the beginning it was Bigfoot guy who'd gotten into the car. They talked for a good 40 minutes about Bigfoot and then Middle Eastern money and how they need to stock up for when the economy collapses. You know your life has hit a new low whenever Bobo and Mike Moneymaker don't believe in your Bigfoot theory. That the Holocaust didn't happen and that Hitler was a good guy for fighting the Zionist evil. So there are dumbasses out there that think the Holocaust didn't happen and that Hitler was basically a good guy. These same guys also claim that anyone who doesn't follow their woke minds is an ignorant sheep. I personally hate these kinds of people. They make complete fools out of themselves. Chemtrails. Especially today after the Jet Airways episode intercept into London. I'm betting those pilots were asleep. I know a guy who legitimately thinks the mob runs the world. Like, there's some mobster sitting in an Italian restaurant in Brooklyn who could snap his fingers and have anyone dead within the hour. He asked me one day why the mob hasn't put out a hit on Trump. I told him. 1. The mob probably wouldn't want him dead. 2. It's not just that simple to knock off a president like that. 3. They're not some omnipotent organization running the world. Italians can't even run Italy. George W. Bush planted explosives in the World Trade Center, offloaded and executed 4 plane loads of civilians, hit the aircraft, then used holograms to hide surface-to-air missiles on live television before performing a controlled demolition. Also, he has an excuse to go after Saddam Hussein over his daddy. So George Bush walked into the World Trade Center, placed tons of explosives without being recognized, walked out and went to a kiddie class all in good enough time to let the explosion off on live TV. I call fake. Hurricane Sandy was created by the government to get Obama re-elected. He needed to carry New York to win, and if it got messed up in a storm, he could be the hero by coming in to clean it up. With all the hot air politicians like to spew, this seems like the most reasonable. Get them all to stand on a boat in the sea, and then get them to deliver their opinions. Thus creating enough hot air to cause a hurricane. Seems legit. A probably schizophrenic man at a CVS told me that all martial arts instructors are part of a worldwide sex abuse conspiracy. He told me to Google martial arts sex abuse. Then he went to the counter and picked up his prescription for flufenazine. Seemed legit. I can't help but wonder if he fixated on that idea because he was abused by a martial arts instructor when he was younger. I really hope not. Either way, I hope that guy's doing okay. Immediately above this post in my feed is a post about Bill Gates sterilizing children with his vaccines. So I'm gonna say that one. The Beatles never existed. John, Paul, George and Ringo were actually a rotating cast of actors musicians, which is why their sound and style changed so much over 8 years. I thought that was the Village People and Kiss. That tsunami that hit Japan was caused by a US launched weather machine as retaliation for Hiroshima, not Pearl Harbor. We were retaliating against Japan for Hiroshima. I was dumbfounded. He even showed me a picture of the weather machine. It was the Voyager probe. This one is gonna sound crazy, but hear me out. In around 2008, I was on YouTube and on a random video I read a comment by a guy convinced he'd been put under a mind control thing by the government. They'd been forcing him to rob banks and steal corporate computers, letting him get arrested and then releasing him to another nearby town to repeat. He said something about how they'd inserted something into his skull after he'd had a minor car crash where he only needed a little attention, but had gained a perfectly straight scar to the side of his head, in front of his ear, while in hospital. These things he was doing were completely out of character from before he had the crash and his family was disowning him. He was begging for help. I looked at his channel and he had a few videos of himself out and about talking about it, all taken at different times but dump uploaded the day I was looking. I watched a couple and subscribed to come back later. I remembered his name too so I could go straight to the URL. The next day I tried to find his account but there was no sign of it. The URL was dead, but not like a regular banned or deleted YouTube account would be. It was as if it had been wiped from existence. I don't think there's a single conspiracy theory I believe, but this story comes to mind every now and again and weirds me out every single time. That Obama is a Kenyan-born Muslim, the Antichrist who purposely came to destroy America. I mean, seriously, people complained so much about Trump being scrutinized and they pulled that crap for 8 years. SMH. I'm aware that that's not all the right-wingers, but I live with somebody who legitimately believes that. My dad used to believe that, but now it's. He was born in Hawaii, and his real dad is a Black Panther member. His birth certificate was photoshopped, but not for any particular reason, because now my dad believes he was born in the US other than the hospital and the DNC being manipulative. That God put dinosaur skeletons into the ground in order to test their faith. I'm sorry, but if that's true, your God is a complete butthole. Yes, that's blasphemy. And yes, I will say it again. Very few Christians believe that. The ones that do just won't shut up about it. That the Stargate franchise was made as a cover for an actual secret military program where an ancient alien device is used for interplanetary travel to acquire advanced technology. If word ever really got out, then they would say it's just a TV show. Whoever believes this is just a nut. Then the episode Wormholes Dream, where a TV show parodying the events of the Stargate program is made, and thus if word got out they have plausible deniability. This episode was made to further discredit speculation that the show was made to cover up something. A buddy of mine once claimed to me that, get this, North and South Dakota are myths. We didn't talk much after that. That with the Earth's new rotation we will start to see new colors that haven't been seen since the Egyptians ruled the Earth. The idea that the Senate is actually an independent governing body that is in no way related to the House, executive or judicial branches of government. I heard this idea from some guys I was in France with last March. Unfortunately, it's likely they were correct, because the next day I was stabbed 23 times on the floor of the Senate. My parents think that Hillary Clinton and Obama are going to shut off the internet, water, and stop commerce because Trump is about to put them in jail. Friend was convinced that AIDS was made in a military base and purposely spread to eradicate people. I didn't know how to respond. That NASA sent a probe to Saturn's moon, Titan, loaded with uranium in order to detonate the uranium, which would destroy Titan and open up a wormhole which would allow George Bush and his cabinet to escape the dying Earth and travel to another point in the universe. The Donald Trump campaign was invented by the New World Order to make Hillary Clinton more palatable to the masses. Guess the joke's on them. There's a few. I'm from a place with tons of conspiracy theory, aliens, crystals type stuff. That Sherry Papini case that was recently big took place in my hometown. I saw a lot of weird things, and I'm still seeing weird things come out of there. That she represents the end of times as the Virgin Mother being branded or whatever. I don't delete these people from Facebook because it's pretty freaking weird and entertaining. Another thing to come out of my hometown was the whole geoengineering contrails chemtrails bulls. That got really bad like 2 years ago. Being a chemist and aeronautic nerd that is friends with a lot of pilots and been watching planes my entire life, this one was really hard to see. I got blocked by a lot of people by trying to explain the contrail was, and they have always existed, it's just physics and chemistry that is well known. It was super frustrating because they kept the local government involved in uncovering the poison. It's like, okay, this city is directly under a major international flight path. It sees a lot of high altitude planes, and always has. If you have flown from California to Europe, you have flown over my parents' house. It's just where the flight path is, and there isn't freaking anything around there. Brain control? Why the frick would they spray things at 30,000 feet up over a small crap valley town? Also, if they are spraying directly over the town like these people think they are seeing, any particulate is going to get blown east over Nevada. There are like 20 people that live in Nevada. It just doesn't make any sense to me. These are also anti-vaxxer type people, but the anti-vax movement seems to have died down quite a bit, which is really good. I'm seeing a lot of pro-vax posts now, from some previous anti-vax mothers or whatever. I'm not going to hate on the anti-vax movement a whole lot unless actually arguing with an anti-vaxxer. I actually think it was valid movement and that parents want to know what is being injected into their children. Not understanding vaccines is something that is forgivably not understood. It's complicated. Without a science background, it's really complicated. Crap, I wouldn't want people telling me what to inject in my body, especially when there's mercury and formaldehyde in the injection. That sounds like poison. Yes, it doesn't sound good, but understanding the role of an adjuvant in vaccination and understanding the chemistry of HG and formaldehyde and the amounts being used is kind of important in understanding the reason for them being in there. Anyways, I tried to educate and I think I have gotten it across to quite a few people, but I've also been blocked for arguing against anti-vaxxers, so there are still a few out there as far as I know. One lady told of me that Obama is a secret Muslim and supported gay marriage so he could later easily identify them, round them up and murder them. I like the Venus plus Serena both had gender modification when they were under 8/9, so they could dominate the female tennis scene. My homophobic grandparents think that Let It Go from Frozen is actually about coming out of the closet. Basically, they think Frozen is actually pushing an agenda. That the Pulse nightclub massacre was staged and that the people you saw in the news were actors flown in who'd been spotted at other mass murders. I've met a couple of people who believe that the attempted bombing that led to liquids being banned on flights was actually a conspiracy by the soda industry to drive up sales by forcing us to pay inflated airport prices for drinks. The best part too is I posted this once before on a thread similar to this some time back and was told by a number of commenters that that seemed perfectly believable and they couldn't understand why I was trying to claim it was ridiculous. Just in case you needed a reminder of how many idiots there are on this site. That the New England Patriots Super Bowl streak is a conspiracy to bolster patriotism after the 9/11 attacks. This guy I worked with a couple years back believed this. He was convinced Belichick and Brady were in on it. His proof? The Patriots only started winning after 9/11. The conspiracy that the Nelson Mandela effect, creating false memories, like remembering brand names or lyrics wrong, is not a result of crappy memory but actually dimensions overlapping. Many people seriously believe that reality is being altered because they remember Cap'n Crunch as Captain Crunch. What conspiracy theories do you think are too logical to ignore? Denver Airport being a fallout shelter for the elite. The fact that it went like a billion over budget and all the symbolism. Comma a billion. 3 billion. 1. Kennedy gets elected. 2. Kennedy is critical of the CIA, his own VP and military for wanting to turn the Cold War into a hot one and the willingness to perform false flag operations. Project Northwoods. To do it. 3. Kennedy is shot. 4. His VP takes power. 5. Classified. You missed out the most important part. He bangs Marilyn Monroe. The art trade. that these million-dollar art shows individual pieces that go for insanely high prices are just a way for money laundering. Tax write-off even. So a real estate friend of mine told me that if you made $1 million you should get a crappy painting done. Have a mate who happens to be an art critic or evaluator value the piece at 50k, then donate that piece to charity stating its value. That allows you to claim a deductible of 50k towards your taxable income due to your charitable donation. A genius. David Miscavige, the chairman of the Church of Scientology, definitely murdered his wife and is getting off scot-free for it. Him and his wife got into a pretty heated argument in 2007, and she hasn't been seen since. Lawyers hired by David claim she is still alive and devotes 100% of her time to work at the Church of Scientology, which is why she hasn't been seen since August 2007. In 2013, a former member of the church had filed a missing person report that was closed after a few officers had spoken and seen Mrs. Miscavige. Even though there's no evidence whatsoever of this meeting, all missing persons reports now are turned down since this investigation is forever closed. Leah Remini has had it investigated as well and written letters to Shelley with no response. Before Leah left the church, she wrote letters to Shelley that the church refused to deliver, and when she asked where Shelley was, she was told she didn't have clearance to ask that question. This one is small and local but still too insane to ignore and just came up today. Just recently, our small suburban town's favorite gas station went out of business. Everyone went there. The guy who ran it was the mayor. He retires and sells the property after an issue with the ground underneath the gas pumps. They tear down the gas pumps and keep the garage. Mavis Tile bought the property and opened a new store. A few days after the Mavis opens, someone posts a picture on Facebook of an intersection at a road near it with nails all over the road. The guy theorizes that a box of nails fell off of a construction truck. The police come clean it up and it seems all is well. Fast forward a few days later and people are commenting on the post that they're finding nails in their car tires. Not just from that intersection. People jokingly say maybe it was the new Mavis guys throwing nails around, but nothing really happens. Several weeks later, people have been posting day in and day out pictures of nails in their car tires. My dad took my car into the Mavis in question about 3 weeks ago and they found a nail inside of the right front tire. I noticed that it was driving sort of funny, but never that my tire was on the verge of exploding. But I jokingly said people have been saying you guys have just been going around throwing nails all over the place, trying not to laugh at how insane it sounded to say out loud. The guy behind the counter said nothing but yeah with a weird smirk. Over 50 people have posted on the town Facebook that their cars have had nails in their tires. My mom is driving my car now because her car has a nail in the tire. It's been almost 3 months. I'll post updates if anyone is interested. So my dad actually confirmed a popular Reddit conspiracy theory. I told him about the laundry detergent caps have the full line too high on purpose, and he told me this was true. He interned at P&G, and they taught him the full line was for the highest level of cleanliness our product can give. You can get away with using much less detergent. The Denver Airport theory. I mean, the capstone of the building literally has the Freemason logo on it. There's some weird butt apocalypse murals on the walls. The runways look like a swastika. And there's a 50-foot tall horse statue with red glowing eyes. I mean, seriously, who the frick designed that place? Building the airport cost $3 billion more than expected and the labor was piecemeal out through countless contractors. So nobody who built it knows the full scope of it. Oh, and that 50-foot tall horse statue with red glowing eyes killed its creator. Deer is a weird place. US intelligence conducting organized blackmail operations out of Epstein's Island. The prosecutor handling Epstein's old case was told to back off and go easy because Epstein was intelligence. Acosta's departure from the administration confirmed that this was not just a rumor. So as an American, I would really like to know exactly who was blackmailing who, how far it extended, and what political decisions were affected. Dr. Claw is Inspector Gadget. Explain. Some torture devices such as the Iron Maiden were made up hundreds of years later so people would think, well, a regular hanging ain't too bad then. This is literally true as far as the Iron Maiden. I'm pretty sure one of the Simon Whistler things talked about this like last week. Nutley NJ, where Martha Stewart was born, has a butcher shop every other corner. How much meat does one small blue-collar town need? Suspicious. This gives me hot fuzz vibes, lol. That BW that used to work in accounting stole the succulent I had on my office desk. She always made comments about how much she loved it. Then she quit her job here. I come into work the next day and it's mysteriously nowhere to be found. Haven't seen it since. With all the scientists in the world, there has to be at least one secret lab on this planet where they have cloned a human. Trader Joe's makes their parking lot small intentionally to make it seem like it's more popular. Ah yes, as opposed to those Walmart parking lots that are one stroke four full. That come on Reddit really does nothing. That's exactly the thing I hate about a Reddit. Karma makes being active on Reddit a competition. A competition with no reward. My dog did not go to Doggy Disneyland because he won a lifetime ticket for being a good boy. I think that he in fact died. Our phones and all the apps on them are listening to conversation. I'm super anti-conspiracy theory, but this has happened to me way too many times in the last 2 years. I impulse shop really, really badly. I carry cash for the explicit purpose of I can use this guilt-free for an impulse purchase. 2 years ago I bought high-end lipstick with cash in a store after doing zero research on the brand. Next day I had ads for it despite never even previously hearing of that company before. I had only talked with a sales associate about the brand for a while. 6 months later, a very similar thing happened when I switched hair care products to very specific brand. Later that night I had ads for their company which I had never heard of or looked up pre or post purchase. 8 months ago I ordered a cider I had never heard of at a bar in Nick. Didn't research the company or anything about it. Not even 2 hours after I left the restaurant I had ads for that brand of cider on my Facebook. There's easily 5-7 more times I could think of, but these are the ones that bother me the most because I am positive the transactions were all in cash. I had never looked up the product before. And I had very targeted specific ads from those exact companies less than a day later on most of my social media. I know how location services work and that's how advertisers get a lot of data because of where you go and shop. But shopping at a huge store with hundreds of brands, Ulta, Sephora, Macy's, etc. What are the odds I got an ad for the exact products I bought? Like genuinely, they weren't on sale, weren't researched, the sales reps didn't help me find them. Same thing with the bar, they carry dozens of brands of booze and specialty beers and stuff. What are the collective odds I got a multiple specific ads for the exact brand of cider I ordered off of a menu of 50 plus drinks? That's the weird part. If I had just gotten generalized targeted ads for those stores or random products in those stores, fine. Or if I had gotten ads for stuff I had bought before it researched a lot, also fine. But the odds of 3 ads for highly specific brands items within a day of me buying those items from a large broad store in cash is just too much. Even the most advanced algorithm couldn't have predicted a spontaneous $100 Lorac MAC lipstick purchase with the only data being this person is in Ulta and has googled Urban Decay eyeshadow before. Totally believe. Never did any research about martial arts or anything, but mention wanting to learn Krav Maga whilst grabbing coffee with a friend. And suddenly I get a ton of ads for Krav Maga and JI Jiu-Jitsu courses. I like that people always are worried that Epstein was murdered instead of suicide. What if this was a ploy to cover up that he just escaped or paid his way out of prison? Well, crap. The FBI keeps posting questions like this to see what the public knows. When someone actually says something that could hurt them, they either spam with accounts that's BS or just delete the account whatsoever. McDonald's shake machines are never actually down. The night crew people are just too lazy to clean it. That's usually the case from what I've been told by people who I know that work at McDonald's. They're basically like it's a giant pain in the butt to clean and it takes literal hours to do. Some people had to talk about Fight Club, otherwise, it wouldn't exist. Tyler Durden instructing people to not talk about Fight Club isn't aimed at getting them to stop talking about Fight Club, it's teaching them to break rules. Or at least, that's how I always thought of it. Google Maps only asks you for feedback on its navigation when it knows it did a good job. I use navigation all the time, and I find that when it gets me to the destination on time or earlier than predicted, I get a notification asking to rate the trip. But if it gets me there after it originally estimated, I never get that notification. It wouldn't be difficult to program this into the program, so you're likely correct. Google probably figures they don't want to ask you right after they did a bad job. Jamie Lynn Spears was raped by Dan Schneider. He is the father of her first child. He ruined Zoe 101. Time to sort by controversial. Guys, I know this is a really crazy theory, but I think some rich people might be corrupt. The US government's involvement in the crack C epidemic. Jamie Lynn Spears, Miranda Cosgrove, Victoria Justice, etc. were violated by Dan Schneider. Nickelodeon let him get away with a lot. There's so many feed jokes in all those shows. A lot of the interviews with those cast members get really awkward when they're around Dan. If you got to pursue your dream career when you really wanted it, wouldn't you do just about anything? If you made Dan Schneider mad, your career would be ruined and your dreams would be over. The fashion industry makes too much money from purses to care about making pockets for women easily available. The idea that there are too many chicken wings for the amount of chickens sold. There is something like a billion chicken wings sold every Super Bowl. Where are they coming from? For your information, the moon landings were real. In fact, there were 6 in total and it's not hard to achieve. The real moon landings were the friends we made along the way. Typing in your email address to unsubscribe from a mailing list actually enters it into more mailing lists. If it's a legitimate list that you signed up for, I don't believe it's true. When it's random spam from nowhere, it's definitely using this to confirm it's a mailbox someone looks at. This is why I never unsubscribe and report spam. I just report spam if I didn't sign up for it. NASCAR is fake. It's just Hot Wheels going around a track and all the sounds are made by one guy in a sound booth imitating what he thinks a race car would sound like. The evidence is out there. Wake up, people. That the US knowingly left POWs behind in Vietnam. Amazon Go isn't about replacing cashiers, but about selling stock, receiving tax breaks for R&D and selling marketing analytics on the shoppers. This is why the stores are placed in financial districts and aren't open 24 hours on the weekend. Their camera system is backed up by employees watching you. Google Amazon Go Chicago. They're closed right now. That's not really a conspiracy theory. That's how marketing research for a technology like this works. I believe that the US government has men in black that make people disappear if they know more than what's good for them. Welp, you're screwed now. Secret societies definitely exist. Jar Jar Binks was supposed to be a Sith Lord and the big bad of the Star Wars prequels, but George Lucas screwed up the directing and then chickened out after seeing the public reception of the character. See also our Darth Jar Jar. The true conspiracies are right in front of our eyes. The extent of corporate control over the democratic process is no secret, but we're all too busy debating the moon landing, flat earthers and anti-vaxxers. New Coke was a way for Coca-Cola to switch from real sugar to corn syrup without people noticing. Switch to the new formula that everyone hates. Keep it for a while so that people demand the old one back. Then switch it back after enough time has passed that people wouldn't notice the relatively subtle change. I thought it was just a ploy to drive up sales and the stock price. Switch to a new formula which people don't like. Alex still continue to buy out of habit because Coke is such an institution. Then release Coke Classic, which everyone misses, and the sales skyrocket. Mike Bloomberg is a ploy by YouTube to get us all to get YouTube Premium to stop seeing his ads. This isn't a conspiracy theory, but I find any chance I can to say that dinosaurs definitely had feathers and deniers are just clinging to Spielberg's image of them. Ostriches are basically velociraptors. Update. Yeah, I get it. Cassowaries exist. The NFL manipulates its games just enough in order to get the best product out of their season because they are a business with billions of dollars on the line. With the number of millionaire billionaires that are psychopaths or similar, there must be a few super rich serial killers out there. By extension, there must be people making money supplying victims in the same way Epstein was supplying girls to the wealthy who wanted to scratch an itch. With the money, power and influence would come governments and intelligence agencies willing to overlook or cover up terrible actions for leverage. This makes sense to me. When you can literally buy anything, the only interesting things become those things you aren't supposed to be able to get. Nothing's actually happening in Area 51. The government just keep it so people will focus on it and ignore the shady stuff happening somewhere else. Actually, Area 51 was created during the Cold War as a testing and development facility for aircraft, including the U-2 and SR-71 Blackbird reconnaissance planes, and currently it's probably being used to test few weapons and that's it. Every country has their secret projects and we all know it. The entire alien and conspiracy theories have only fueled movies and TV shows. That's it. I quite like the missing cosmonauts theory. It's unlikely but seems like it could have been possible. It boils down to the idea that Yuri Gagarin wasn't the first man in space. He was just the first man in space to survive the entire process. There was nothing found about any of this in the Soviet archives after the fall of the USSR. We don't know who killed Kennedy. Here's the thing about Kennedy. The fact that Jack Ruby killed Oswald should be all anyone needs to know to convince them Oswald didn't act alone. The theory that Epstein didn't kill himself. Memes aside, he could have probably exposed a lot more rich people for their debaucheries. They just bumped him off before he could do so. I don't consider that a conspiracy theory. It's just plain fact honestly. ETA the word theory. Which conspiracy theory came out real? That the sugar industry paid scientists to blame fat instead of sugar for heart disease and various other health issues. I actually cut a lot of sugar out of my life and I've felt less jumpy and agitated. I'm starting to learn more about how much sugar there actually is in everything we consume. It's insane. Even small amounts so we don't hate the food we eat. Crash gut. In a nutshell, Fernando Alonso is starting the 2008 Singapore Grand Prix from quite a bad position. Actually, the normal strategy when in a competitive car starting at the back is to load her up with fuel and go as far as you can into the race before pitting. Weirdly, Alonso is instead one of the first to pit. The only possible way this can work is if the safety car comes out due to how the rules are enforced. Well, exactly one lap later, Alonso's teammate has a big crash into the wall and brings out the safety car, allowing Alonso to go on and win. At the time, many were accusing Alonso's Renault team of fixing the result due to how convenient it was for the safety car to come out at exactly the right time after the other car crashed. But hey, that's just a coincidence, right? It wasn't a coincidence. It turned out Alonso's teammate was indeed told to crash by the team principal to benefit the team by scoring a win. This all came out in 2009, after the second driver lost his seat for not being quick enough. These are the two that come in my mind. Ustica. Tobacco company knew that the cigarettes caused cancer but they falsified the test so they can sell their product freely. How about when Johnson & Johnson knew that their talc powder had too much asbestos in it which can cause cancer and they kept selling it to be used on babies. They're still getting sued for mesothelioma and ovarian cancer. Lots of women used it on their lady parts. A man named John Woronowski used to stand outside the Vatican Embassy the 90s in Washington, D.C. with a sign saying that the Pope is hiding pedophile priests. He claimed to be a victim of such abuse. People would honk and throw insults junk at him and call him crazy. I met him back in 2011. I recorded in my journal. There was a guy from sorapope.com protesting in front of the Vatican Embassy. I talked to him a little bit. He said he had been protesting at that location for the last 13 years because he was sexually abused when he was 15 years old and it negatively influenced his life. One you've never heard of. There were tales at my high school of the 100 hall, where all the halls with numbered rooms and lockers started at 200 and went up. So there was number 100 hall. The wild story was that it's underground, built to be a bomb shelter with stored non-perishables, and had entrances in the auditorium and gym. Turns out, absolutely true. The one aspect of it that didn't pan out was the attached tunnel that led to the science building at the local university. We had a similar story at my university. Secret tunnels under the campus. I think some do exist but I don't remember the story well enough. My mate was into YouTube conspiracy when it was big I am talking lizard people type crap. He talked about spillionaire who has an island of little girls you can have sex with and drink wine. And drink wine lol. The Echelon program. I'm amazed this one doesn't come up more. It was treated as a real tinfoil hat loony conspiracy theory for years. I remember it being mentioned in a couple of films in the 90s, I think by crazy conspiracy theorist type characters. Then Snowden blew his whistle and I was amazed how many details were right. The CIA used military personnel with diagnoses of everything from depression to PTSD and even schizophrenia as guinea pigs for experimental medicines and treatments. They once gave a group of mentally ill men massive doses of LSD and left them all in a room for several days just to see what would happen. One survivor wrote that he spent those days perceiving the other men as living corpses and that the walls were covered in blood. There is no accurate number for how many people were killed or otherwise traumatized for life. Project MKUltra began in 1953 and continued for 20 years, only finally being dismantled in 1973. Keyword there officially. It probably is unofficially going on still. That various governments recorded, analyzed, and stored every single piece of digital information anyone shared with anyone else. For you younger people, this used to be one of those tinfoil hat conspiracies. I can remember when it first started to become known there were people who would argue they didn't care because they had nothing to hide and weren't guilty. Most of the ones I still know are the most rabid about gov't going too far these days. It's kinda like former smokers can be the worst anti-smoking people. The CIA overthrew the democratically elected government of Iran to install the Shah, who was more friendly to the US in the 1950s. The FBI and local law enforcement stalked, harassed, and blackmailed MLK Jr. They tried to get him to kill himself. They assassinated a leader of the Black Panthers in Chicago and then concocted bogus criminal charges against all the witnesses of the murder to lock them up and discredit them. They had undercover leaders infiltrate basically every single social justice movement and had a whole playbook based around how to make those movements look more radical, violent, dangerous than they actually are to discredit them. Undercover officers and confidential informants at protests throw bricks or try to start violence. Local law enforcement, prosecutors, and the FBI all lied to judges, juries, grand juries, legislatures, and Congress saying they never did things like this. People had to break into an FBI field office and steal documents to prove they were actually doing this stuff and had to keep their identities secret for decades so they wouldn't be prosecuted or persecuted for their actions. And the FBI and local law enforcement still do this stuff but everyone acts like they don't. COINTELPRO will change the way you look at media, government, and law enforcement. Well, no one really knew about it until I believe the 90s, so there would have been no theorizing. But in the early 60s the US Joint Chiefs of Staff drew up a plan called Operation Northwoods in which they planned on staging and committing terror attacks across the US, only to turn around and blame it on Cuba in order to justify an invasion. You can see why JFK ended up dead. Crack epidemic was fueled and facilitated by the CIA. Documents came out proving the connection between Central American drugs for guns deals and distribution though freeway Rick Ross in LA in the 80s. Half of America is built on drug money. All of Florida at least. Haven't seen anyone talk about Malcolm X's assassination. An NYPD former officer talked about how NYPD and FBI worked together to get his bodyguards removed so that an assassination could take place. Yes, and they recently just exonerated the guys they pinned this on. I remember reading about Epstein's Island in 2012. It had a website and everything. Back then it was a conspiracy theory, but now it's all common knowledge. The village people were paid by the US Armed Forces to write in the Navy, to be used as a recruiting tool towards gay people when the armed forces were banned from recruiting gay people. The Simpsons definitely clowned on this idea, even E.H.T. Niage. While not necessarily 100% proven true, there was a long and expensive congressional investigation into the John F. Kennedy assassination in the late 1970s. Their conclusion? That Kennedy was probably assassinated as part of a conspiracy. And nobody remembers. It's like the Snowden thing. Expect public outcry. Get silence. MKUltra. A bunch of college kids in Montreal said that America was testing substances on them. Comes out later that the CIA had actually recruited hundreds of students at the University of McGill under the guise of participating in scientific research. The CIA proceeded to dose the poor students with insane levels of LSD and practiced torture and interrogation techniques on them. They also gave soldiers LSD. My dad was a Korean vet and he told me when I was a kid that they gave him something to dissolve in his mouth and he tripped for 3 days. He didn't know what it was. I'm assuming LSD. CIA-backed coups in socialist and or democratically elected countries. MKUltra. Tuskegee experiments. Nazis got the US to the moon. PRISM. Data mining. Panama Papers. Paradise Papers. And the most jarring being that 6 mega corporations own all US media outlets. It's actually 5 now. 2 core merged. The British royal family being deeply involved in an elite pedophile ring. Turned out only one was a pedophile and the rest were just happy for him to get on with it. More than one. Philip's uncle, Louis Mountbatten, whom Charles adored, is also being outed as a pedophile, but didn't stop William from naming both his sons after him. The whole German-Mexican thing before World War I. For those not familiar, Germany basically hit Mexico up and was like, hey, want some US land, but Britain, I think, intercepted the message and gave it to the US, who were not amused. Mexico ended up dropping it. This is from memory, so correct me if I got something wrong. Good memory. It was called the Zimmermann Telegram. Weird that Germany never gave it a thought that the telegraph lines that they used went through Great Britain and might be tapped. That kids' laughter is a better source of energy than their screams. This was revealed to be true in the tell-all documentary called Monsters, Inc. in 2001. Hottest take here. That there's a society of billionaires and millionaires who run a ring of children discreetly, and anyone who talks or goes to talk winds up dead. The movie and music industry, royal family, government, it runs really really deep. MKUltra, the Tuskegee experiments, the US and UK overthrowing Iran, Bush, Blair, and other leaders lying about Iraq, the Gulf of Tonkin, the Pentagon Papers, the list goes on and on. That the government is spying on you through your devices, which in retrospect made sense even back then, but we just didn't want to believe it. Alex Jones like 10 years ago was telling people that there was an island that famous people would be brought to and be filmed having sex with minors. As we now know, this was as Jeffrey Epstein's island. MKUltra, a government project which was carried out by the CIA. This project was set to achieve mind control through torture, sexual abuse, physical abuse and the use of different machinery and drugs. The American government experimenting on people without their knowledge or consent. Look up Tuskegee experiment. The really wild thing is that we all know this happened, and yet if you even suggest the possibility that the government would do something like it again, people dismiss you and act like you're a conspiracy theorist. It's both hilarious and pathetic. Didn't they also illegally sterilize many women? The existence of child sex trafficking rings with multiple high-ranking politicians being involved, which is unfortunately being overshadowed by the idiocy of canon as of late, to the point where anyone bringing it up is immediately associated with those nut jobs. That there were bodies of children who attended residential schools buried there that were never reported. For decades, the local diocese of the Catholic Church, who call people making these claims lunatics and harassers, until ground surveying equipment found 215 in Kamloops, which in turn led to more searches and more bodies across the country. In Australia, when COVID first hit, the government introduced a mobile phone app for COVID Safe, where you can scan the QR code everywhere and it'll track where you are for contact tracing. The government said it's safe. We will only use the information gathered to track for COVID only. I said this. I'm refusing to use it because I don't trust the government. There's already been hacks in other government departments and personal data lost, and I don't trust the government app on my device where they can update and change what the program does. And I also don't trust them to not use the data for other reasons like they said they wouldn't. Note here, I'm not a conspiracy nut job. I do like a good conspiracy theory, but you need to use science and reason. I'm not canon or anything like that at all, and I'm double vaxxed and personally think anti-vaxxers are idiots. In this specific situation, I didn't trust the program, data or government. Guess what happened? The government used the app and data for other things, like they said they wouldn't. Police in Queensland, Western Australia and Victoria have all owned up to trying to access logs of data created by Australians using Checkr applications as part of their investigations. Western Australia had to actually enact a law stating that the data could only be used for covert tracing. Western Australia police actually said it's not illegal for us to use the data, so we are going to continue to use the data if we see fit when questioned by the state government about what they were doing. The actual audacity. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.